September 14 marks the feast day of our school, Holy Cross Catholic Academy, when the Church celebrates the cross itself as the instrument of humanity's salvation. But this feast day has a very rich and varied tradition dating back to the year 326 AD, when St. Helena discovered the true cross of Jesus, which had disappeared after the crucifixion. St. Helena was the mother of Emperor Constantine, who miraculously converted to Christianity and brought to an end the persecution of Christians within the Roman Empire that had raged virtually from the time of Christ's death. Helena, like her son Constantine, also became a devout Christian and was sent by the Emperor to the Holy Land in 326 AD to recover what she could of the artifacts of Jesus and his apostles, particularly those associated with Christ's death and resurrection. Her task was not an easy one. History tells us that every attempt was made by Emperor Hadrian to destroy all traces of the site where Jesus had been crucified and buried. He had hoped to extinguish the faith of Christians by making it impossible to worship at the site of Jesus' crucifixion and resurrection. He had the ground around Golgotha covered with earth, and temples and statues to Jupiter and Venus built on the site. The tomb of Jesus was very near the site of his crucifixion, and the Gospels tell us that the bodies of Jesus and the two criminals crucified with him were removed quickly as the feast of the Passover was fast approaching. The crosses of Jesus and the two thieves had been hurriedly buried into the ground at the place where they were crucified. It was customary for the Jews to bury the instruments of the death with the corpses of criminals, as they considered those objects defiled. When Emperor Constantine's mother, Helena, arrived in Jerusalem, she began an exhaustive investigation to find the site of the crucifixion. With the help of a local Jewish man who acted as her guide, the site of the tomb was established. Emperor Constantine ordered the pagan temples built over the burial spot of Jesus demolished and the site excavated. First, the tomb, which had been hidden for so long, was discovered. Then, three crosses were also uncovered, buried near the Lord's tomb along with other objects, like the nails and the spear used to pierce Jesus' heart. The title that Pilate had put on the cross of Jesus had been lying separate from the crosses, so Helena was not sure which cross was the cross of Jesus. With the help of Macarius, Bishop of Jerusalem, the true cross was identified. He took the crosses to a well-known lady in Jerusalem who was sick, lying at the point of death. While praying, Macarius, one by one, lay each cross on the woman. The first two had no effect, but when the third cross touched her, the woman suddenly opened her eyes and got up, all her strength restored. After the cross of Jesus had been identified in this way, Helena built a church over the place where she had discovered the cross. Part of the cross she sent back to Rome, and can be seen in the church that had once served as her own private chapel, the Church of the Holy Cross in Jerusalem. She also left a part in Jerusalem, in the church she had built on the site of her discovery of the cross and our Lord's empty tomb, the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. And so it is fitting that at the heart of our school is our chapel, and adorning the wall to its entrance a fresco depicting the event of St. Helena discovering the true cross of Christ. It is also fitting that our chapel be named the St. Helena Chapel. May it serve as a place of prayer and worship for the students and staff of Holy Cross for many years to come.